Okay, so this is a pretty typical setup for what you might find if you're editing in DaVinci Resolve. So let's say we've got our edit finished and we want to export our timeline. Now there's a couple of ways to go about this, but I'm going to show you the quickest and the easiest way first. So without doing anything else in the timeline here currently, all you need to do is go to File, go down to Quick Export. You don't want to hit Export here because this is where you kind of collect all of your timeline and project files, but what you want is Quick Export, and that will open up this little dialog box. And basically it's going to hit with a couple of presets, and you can hit Export and you will get a video that is ready to go. So if you don't know what you're doing at all and you just need to export your video from DaVinci Resolve, for the web, H.264 master is what you want, or the YouTube master, and it will be a very similar output. Now, if you do want to render a higher quality version of your project, go with ProRes, and this would be something that you would keep on a hard drive as kind of like a master file. But if you're uploading to the web, H.264, or specifically if you know you're uploading to YouTube or Vimeo, Twitter, or Dropbox, pick those ones there. Okay, so that's the very quick export. Now, if we're going slightly more in depth, what I suggest you do, and this is the workflow that I usually do when I finish a project, I start in the edit page here by setting my in and out points. So your in point, if you haven't already set it, will automatically be at 0000, very start of your timeline. What I want to do is I just want to click anywhere around here, hit up on my keyboard to go to the very end of my clip here and hit O on my keyboard. And there you can see we've got our in and out point set. So let's just play this through. So that's our in point and we can just play this through, and then we've got our footage and our out point is set to where it ends. So from the edit page here, we're down in the edit page, go over to the deliver page, which is this little rocket ship icon right here. So that brings us into basically what we did with the quick export box before, but the more in-depth version. So up on the left-hand side here, we've got those presets like we had before, H.264 master, H.265 master, ProRes, YouTube, so on and so forth. Again, if you know where you're heading, i.e. YouTube, click on that, and that will give you everything that you basically need to export to YouTube. All right, but then again, just let's say that we're going to H.264 master. If we do want to edit some things over here, we can. So this is where you can put in your file name and your location. So we'll do that quickly now. And then you can choose a few other things. So you want to make sure you're rendering single clip, not individual clips, unless there's specifically you do want to render out individual clips, you can do that. Single clip, video, export video, format. So if we want a H.264, I would suggest for most applications for uploading to the web, you want to go to MP4 and you want to have your codec set to H.264. Leave these checked. Resolution, 1920 by 1080. If you're working with 4K media, such as I am here, we can go down and we can search for 3840 by 2160 Ultra HD. We'll keep that there. Frame rate, keep that as is for your project. I'm working in 25, you might be working in a different frame rate. Now quality here, most of the time just set it to automatic. If you do know that you've got specific bitrate settings for your export location, for instance, YouTube has some bitrate settings and restrictions depending on the quality of the file that you're uploading. If you know that, you can go ahead and change that here, but honestly, just leave it on automatic. And then at the other end, on the YouTube end, they'll handle that. If you do want to get just a little bit more quality out of it, do a multi-pass encode as well. But for the most part, if you just hit these presets, you are good to go. So once you've done that, you can go add to render queue, and I've changed the resolution from my timeline, but that's okay. We can hit add and we can go over here to our render queue and then simply hit render all. And there we go. That's rendering right now. We'll play some elevator music in the background while this happens. But it didn't take too long at all, so no need to have too much elevator music. Well, there we go. That's it. That's how you render and export video in DaVinci Resolve. There's the quick export way, and then the slightly less quick, but still pretty quick export way. I hope that helped. This little tutorial is brought to you by Envato Elements. Now, Elements is a subscription for creative assets, and with your subscription, you get access to millions of digital assets, like stock footage, music, sound effects, video templates, and more. And you also get unlimited downloads, so you can grab a heap of assets and see what works in your project without having to worry about any credits or watermarks or anything like that. There's also no lock-in contract, so check out the link in the video description below, sign up today and see how well it fits into your workflow.